One of the most well-known airfoil series or families of airfoils is called the NACA four-digit series. So NACA stands for, this is just off of Wikipedia here, but NACA stands for the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics. It was founded in 1915 and basically was the research branch of the government, funded by the U.S. government to do research in aeronautics. And in 1958, it was dissolved and combined or swallowed up into NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. But for 43 years, it operated as a very important agency that studied aeronautics, and they came up with their own families of airfoils. The NACA four-digit series is just one of those. They have actually several different families of airfoils, but the NACA four-digit is rather simple to define, and so is often used as a beginning point, at least when learning aerodynamics. And then you can go into more complicated airfoil geometries later that were developed for specific applications, such as transonic flow or trying to keep the flow laminar over the forward part of the airfoil. Anyway, they had some later series that were more specialized for certain applications, but the NACA four-digit series is a very common one that is discussed in textbooks. And there's a book by Abbott and von Dohenhoff, published in 1949, that basically summarized the airfoil research that NACA had done over the last several years. And anyway, it's an excellent handbook to have if you're interested in learning more about airfoils. In fact, it includes a lot of information at the end of it. About the second half of the book is all experimental wind tunnel data on these airfoils that NACA had tested and collected all this data for. And so they have their plots in the second half of the book. And the first half of the book is more about the theory of airfoil development, some of which we'll be talking about in this class, and what they had learned through their study of airfoils. So the NACA four-digit series is defined with a camber line as a function of x, and a thickness distribution as a function of x, just as we've discussed. We're going to have a camber function and a thickness function. The camber function looks like this. So it's a YMC 2 times x over XMC. I'll come back and define these different variables here in just a moment. X over XMC squared. And that is used from 0 is less than or equal to x less than or equal to XMC. And then YMC 2 times C minus X over C minus XMC minus C minus X over C minus XMC squared. And that is used from XMC up to C. Okay, and then the thickness distribution, I'll just write out here, is T sub M times 2.969 square root of x over C minus 1.260 x over C minus 3.516 x over C squared plus 2.843 x over C cubed minus 1.015 x over C to the fourth, and close parentheses. Okay, so the camber line is a function of a couple things here. We've got XMC, which is the location of of maximum camber. Now remember that our camber line is going to look something like this, where we've got our leading edge and trailing edge, and this is our chord C. And so the location of maximum camber in what I've drawn here would be that X value right there. So that would be XMC. Okay. Then we've also got YMC, and that is the maximum camber value. So this would be YMC. That's the maximum camber. Now, some people just call this the camber, but it's really the maximum camber, because camber goes to zero at the ends. And so if somebody says, you know, I've got a 2% camber airfoil, what they mean is 2% maximum camber. That's the maximum amount of camber there. Okay, so that defines everything up in the camber equation. And then in the thickness equation, we've got T sub M, which is the maximum thickness. And remember that our thickness is going to get added to the camber here. And come around, you know, something like this. And there's some point of maximum thickness. If we were to plot just thickness as a function of X, then you know, it would also have something that kind of looks like that, where it goes to zero at the leading edge and the trailing edge, but there's some maximum thickness here, and that's what T sub M is. That's the maximum thickness. Okay, so the NACA four-digit series uses these equations for the camber line and the thickness, but you can define a whole different family of airfoils, because you can change the values of the location of maximum camber, the actual amount of maximum camber, and the maximum thickness on the airfoil. And those values are defined from these four digits. So let's put, we're gonna have four digits down here. And these are just integer values. And this first one, the first digit here, is the amount of camber. So it's the max camber in percent chord. Okay, the second digit, so this is tied here to the maximum amount of camber. The second digit is the location of max camber, so it's XMC in tenths of chord. And we'll go through an example here in just a moment. And then the final two digits are the thickness in, so it's the TM in percent chord. Those are the final two digits. Okay, so let's look at an example here. So the NACA 2412 is a very common airfoil, so we'll say NACA 2412. So what does that mean? Well, that means that that first digit is the maximum camber. So that means that it has a 2% camber. And so that means that this YMC up here, the height of YMC there is 2% of the chord. Okay, so usually the camber is pretty small. We're talking about 2%, you know, 2/100ths of the length of that chord is how high the camber line is going to come up off of the x-axis. All right, the 4 now tells us that happens at 40% chord, because remember, XMC is in tenths of chord, so the 4 means 4/10, so 40% of the chord. So if we were to move down this chord by 40%, That's the location of maximum camber, is at the 40% location there. And then finally, the 12 here says that this thickness here has a maximum camber of 12%. And so, or excuse me, maximum thickness of 12%. So that means if you were to look at the cross-section here, if we were to cut this camber line always perpendicular to it, the maximum thickness that we would see is 12% of the length of the cord. 12% is a pretty normal thickness, that the thickness is on the order of usually between, sometimes they go down as low as about 6% up to maybe 15 or 17%. So 12% is about halfway through that range there. Anyway, 2412, like I said, is a common airfoil for research purposes and just simple applications that don't need a really well-designed airfoil for that application per se. And so we'll be using it periodically for different examples. But anyway, that's what each of the digits mean in the NACA four-digit series. So now if you're given four digits that define a NACA airfoil, you should be able to take those digits and plug them into these equations to actually plot what that airfoil would look like.